Okay, hi, I'm head of science and also heading up physics at the moment in the science department. So as part of my background, I'm particularly interested in astrophysics and astronomy, which was started off by doing a GCSE in astronomy when I was at school. But if you are going to be interested in the A-level physics, then obviously it's going to cover a whole range of topics, from going from the very small atoms, but even smaller than that, going down to quantum, looking at waves, looking at particles, looking at electricity, looking at mechanics. And it also requires some really good math skills, because this is where maths and science start to combine to help explain some of those really abstract concepts. Saying that, physics can still be super interesting. We do a big range of practicals, so there are core practicals that you have to complete as part of any of the science A levels, and again they'll be using some more specialist equipment than you might be used to at GCSE level. So these core practicals can come up on the exams, and there are three exams that you would do at the end of the course. And again, we spend lots of time looking at developing those skills, as well as doing lots, as I said, the maths equations, looking into being able to use some very specific terminology to describe certain functions, and also give you that good science background in being a critical thinker and being using analytical skills and being able to kind of look at patterns and trends in data. So after doing a physics A-level, obviously you could go on to a physics degree. It also is really supportive of engineering degrees and things like that. But looking progression and career-wise, it also has lots of transferable skills. So as I said, those critical thinking, problem-solving, analytical skills. You might have very good spatial awareness if you're finding physics a good one to get your head around. So there might be fields like engineering, whether it's chemical engineering or materials engineering, structural engineering, or into physics, or even into different industries, or staying in research, as I said, about all the space science. And there's even some very famous physicists that have gone on to have entertainment roles. So you might know Brian May from Queen, or Dara O'Brien, who's a comedian on television. So it doesn't just limit you with a science role.